Good morning, students. So we'll continue with our chapter today, India drainage system. So last period we had seen the type of system, how it flows also. Okay, and Indian rivers are classified as Himalayan rivers, anti-peninsular rivers. So last time we had seen the Himalayan rivers, and which were the three major Himalayan rivers? Indus, Ganga and Brahmaputra. And Ganga and Brahmaputra go and meet which water body? They flow from Himalayas to the western part or eastern part. They go to the eastern part. So which water body? Bay of Bengal. And the others, that is the Indus, will go and meet Arabian Sea. Okay. So today we are going to see the peninsular rivers. The western ghats form a water divide here. Now what is a water divide? What is a water divide? I already told you last time. Keep that in mind. In exam, it can be asked for a one mark answer. What is a water divide? A water divide is an elevated.
A water divide is when any elevated body divides the river or distributaries or something.
Yes,
like
the that. River basins into. Okay, so today we are going to see the peninsular rivers. So major amongst them are Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri. Okay, now once I open the map, you will see in which directions do they flow. They flow to the east. And Narmada and Tapi, they flow to the west. Okay. So quickly, let us study the river basins of each. Now, after this PPT, I'll open the textbook. By the time, you keep the names of the rivers in your mind. Okay. So we have to trace River Narmada on the map. The source is Amarkantak Hills, Madhya Pradesh. So it originates from Amarkantak Hills in Madhya Pradesh. And it flows through Madhya Pradesh and Gujarat. Okay, next is the Tapi River, which originates, or the source is Betul district in Madhya Pradesh, and it flows through parts of Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat and Maharashtra. Runs parallel to Narmada and is shorter in length. So Tapi River runs parallel to Narmada and it is shorter in length than the Narmada River. Okay, now Godavari, the source of origin is Nashik in Maharashtra. It flows through Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Orissa and Andhra Pradesh. It is the longest peninsular river. The length is 1500 kilometers. Okay, it is also known as Dakshin Ganga. Why Dakshin Ganga? Any idea? Dakshin means which direction? South. Dakshin means south. So peninsular region rise in the southern part, right? And the northern plain rise in the northern part. So Ganga is the longest river in the northern side, and in the southern side the longest river is Godavari. Okay, trace river Mahanadi on the map. It originates from Chhattisgarh and flows through Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand and Orissa. So these are the four states it drains on its way. Total length is 860 kilometers. Next is river Krishna on the map. Okay, then the source is Mahabaleshwar in Maharashtra, flows through Maharashtra, Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh. Total length is 1400 kilometers. What was the length of Dakshin Ganga? 1500, correct. This river Kaveri on the map, source is Brahmagiri Range, Western Ghats, flows through Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu and total length is 760 kilometers. Okay. Now, before I open the textbook, we'll finish off with this. Now, are rivers the only sources of water in India? So, we see a lot of lakes in India. Lakes help a country too. Now, in what way are lakes important for us?
Oh, actually, it helps in drinking water.
Hmm?
And even though if we see in villages, where the technology is not that advanced, the villagers use the lake to wash their utensils or wash their clothes and things.
Mm-hmm. Anything else?
They can be used for making like some farm help.
Mm-hmm. Irrigation
could be used for.
Yes.
Yeah, irrigation. Mm-hmm. And we can also like generate some electricity. There is that wheel type way in which they put a large wooden wheel And then when that wheel starts spinning around, it starts generating electricity.
So that is hydel electricity, right?
Hydroelectricity,
right?
Yes, hydroelectricity.
First and foremost, it is helpful to maintain water supply. How to maintain water supply? We will explain this. Right from lower classes, you have done this concept. Which is the water supply? I mean, how is water supply maintained in any country? Is it that we don't use water and we keep it reserved?
No, ma'am.
No.
One is that we shouldn't waste water.
Mm-hmm.
Second is that we should keep the water clean.
Mm-hmm.
Like in cities, we don't get water that clean because of those industrial things and stuff. So we should keep the water clean, and we should make good use of it. We shouldn't do, it with harmful chemicals and stuff.
What you're saying is coming in the next part. Have you heard the concept of water cycle? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
The water
gets
evaporated, then it is, and the clouds are formed and it falls down in the form of precipitation. So lakes are the bodies where the water from the rain gets collected, right? So this is how it maintains the water supply. Then regulate river flow in rainy or dry season. So lakes will help us with, in rainy season or dry season, or in case there is less rainfall. These are the places where you will find stored water. Okay, as you already said, it develops hydel power. Okay, and to maintain aquatic ecosystem. What is an ecosystem? Aquatic ecosystem? It is found in biosphere, right? Where life sustains with the help of other two, that is lithosphere and hydrosphere. So ecosystem is a kind of setup where each organism lives in this food chain world with the help of living and non-living things around him for food and shelter. Right, that is ecosystem. Then attract tourists. Can you give me one example where lakes attract tourists? Are you aware of any such lakes?
Rankara.
Okay, yes.
Then Lake.
Wonderful. Even in Rajasthan, there is this, what is that? The only saltwater lake in India is which? So it will be like kind of tourist spots for everyone.
Ma'am, Lonar Lake.
Lonar? Mm-hmm.
So, first one is Lake Pichola, which is in Udaipur.
Mm-hmm.
The second one is Dal Lake, which is in Srinagar.
Correct.
And the next one is the Nainital Lake, which is in Nainital.
Okay. So, I was looking
And
for
we the... even mm-hmm. have a lake in Maharashtra.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know the exact name of the lake, but... where that the location where the lake is formed, actually that's a meteorite crater.
Okay, you remember the Venna Lake in Mahabaleshwar where you all go boating if you have been to Mahabaleshwar?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, and then
yes,
you have Sambar Lake in Rajasthan, which is the only saltwater lake in India. So that is the way where you actually attract tourists. Okay, and another thing is providing recreation to the citizens and tourists. So like boating or some other activities, if you are organizing there, it is also attracting more and more tourists because it provides with some recreational activities. So that is how these lakes, they also are important to us, like how rivers are important to us. Okay. So in our country, we rely on our rivers, firstly, as you said, for irrigation. Okay. Secondly, for hydropower generation. And all our basic needs as well as navigation. Navigation is for water transport. Okay. So livelihood for Indians is the agriculture. So for agriculture, we need irrigation. So lakes can provide water for that. But when nature has endowed us with so many things, how are we treating our rivers is what Malhar was trying to answer in the beginning. So it is, we don't treat them with respect. Okay, and that is why we have a lot of environmental problems. We treat them how? Whenever we go to visit it, yes, we pollute them. So what happens when we pollute them? The water in them renders to be inefficient for us to drink or for some other use. So we compromise on quality. So we wash clothes in the dirty water only. We wash utensils with the dirty water only. We feed our plants with the dirty water only. And at times, people who don't have all these, I mean, those who are in poverty and cannot afford all these water filtration processes and all, those UV filters and all, they land up drinking water which is unfit for, yes, Malla, right, which is unfit for consumption. And as a result, there are a lot of diseases that are spreading around. So river water is reducing in quality and its self-cleansing capacity. So what we do, you have seen last year, a lot of videos and images about river Ganga where dead bodies were thrown, where people go and they perform some puja and they throw all the flowers and garlands inside. And it is really bothering the environmental beauty and as well as the quality of water that is present in the river. So rivers have some self-cleansing capacity, but not that much. Like, more the amount of dirt we put in it, it becomes increasingly incapable of for any river to self-cleanse itself. So that means a river can handle and dilute a certain amount of pollution, but not all. So we are polluting them all the more by throwing our home trash, by dumping industrial waste. When we don't dump, dump the industrial waste in the desired place, and we just let them loose in the rivers or lakes, it is polluting them. And ultimately, that affects the water that we drink. So why are rivers important for the country's economy? Now, you have to write with the point of view of economic situation. Okay, for irrigation, which helps in producing the crops, then?
I mean, useful in hydropower.
Which helps in saving of the conventional source of energy, right? And?
Drinking water, ma'am, as government takes us.
It's the basic human activities. And also, if you want, for economic purpose, better to add navigational purposes, because it earns money. It helps to earn money because of the transportation route. Okay, water transport. So,
one more thing that we have means we take ticket for to visit that Ganga Nadi, means Ganga River, as it is a holy river. So we take people come to visit that river and just take a holy bath from there. From there also they charge us money. And there also they get a lot of money because daily the more than 50,000 people come to visit that Ganga River. So
yes,
we get money and it.
Yes. I accept that. But ultimately, people, you know, you have to respect people's feelings also. They visit there for holy purposes, because they believe in God, because they believe in the, that thing is sacred. But there are money-minded people who try to make money from that also. That is not good. Yes, human development leads to using these resources for their benefits. But when and where to use it, that also is very, very important. Okay. So now I'll open the textbook and we will see if you can answer the questions or you can trace the route that we were talking of, the rivers, and then I go to the worksheet and quickly go through the questions that are there. So which rivers were we asked to trace? We were asked to trace the river, first and foremost, Narmada. So where can you see Narmada? Can you see here? Narmada?
Yes, ma'am, it's Narmada.
Yes. See, here you can see Narmada. Okay. Okay. So you saw here, this is Narmada. And then lying parallel to it is which river? Tapi, right? Yes. So Narmada and Tapi are both parallel to each other. Then Tapi is smaller in height as, smaller in length as compared to Narmada. Yes. Then this is the Godavari River. The origin is in Nashik, Maharashtra, and it flows through which all states here that you need to see. And then this is Krishna. Origin is Mahabaleshwar in Maharashtra. Okay, then Mahanadi. The origin is Chhattisgarh. And it finally comes out in the Bay of Bengal when all other rivers over here, they meet the Mahanadi. And which system is this? Remember this? Just trellis. Okay. Yes. Then which else was there in the Krishna we saw? Kaveri. This is Kaveri. Yes. Originating in the Brahmagiri range in Western Hills, Western Ghats here. Okay. Western Ghats, this side. And then it drains the state of Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Okay. This is it. Okay. Now in your worksheet, let's see, they have some questions based on, let's see if you can actually name those rivers. Which river has the largest basin in India? Largest basin is Ganga. Okay.
Oh.
Then which states does the Indus pass through? Indus River. Indus River will pass through which states? See here, Indus, which states? Jammu and Kashmir. Then?
Oh, yes, ma'am.
Here, Himachal. Right? Himachal. Then, which else? And rest is in Pakistan. Yes. So, which states? Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal, Punjab, Chandigarh, and the remaining part is in Pakistan. Okay? Now, which is the next? In which states do Chambal, Betwa and Son join the Ganga? In which states do the Chambal, Betwa and Son? Chambal is here.
Madhya Pradesh.
Betwa, where do they join? Okay, they join in Madhya Pradesh. And so Chambal and Betwa, they join, which river is asked? Yamuna, right? Okay, the Ganga. So, which state? Yes, obviously the answer is correct, no? The Ganga. They see, Chambal is coming and meeting here Yamuna first, and then Yamuna flows further to meet Ganga, right? Same with Betwa. So, Betwa is meeting Yamuna at, again,
Madhya Pradesh.
Yes, and all three of them go and meet at which place? That is Allahabad.
Bengal, the river Sun. Sun River meets to Ganga in West Bengal, I think. Yes,
no, West Bengal is this side, not exactly West Bengal. See, Chambal and Betwa join Yamuna at Etwa district. Okay, Chambal, and they first meet Yamuna. Okay. And as we move to the east, Yamuna joins Ganga. See, first these two, they join Yamuna. Then Yamuna joins Ganga at Allahabad, which is the Triveni Sangam. So here the answer will be, for your question, the answer will be Madhya Pradesh. Okay. Then which is the largest riverine island formed by the Brahmaputra?
Majuli.
Okay.
With an area of 352 square kilometers.
Okay. Fine. Majoli. Okay. Then the states in which Sabarmati, Mahi, Bharatpuzha and Periyar drain water. So Sabarmati, everybody has studied in the previous history classes.
Gujarat.
So it will drain which? Gujarat.
Gujarat.
It is moving further. So don't forget, it is moving through Rajasthan also. Yes, it is going through Rajasthan also before it goes and drains in Arabian Sea. Then next is which? Next is Mahi.
Yes, Mahi River.
But Mahi drains this Madhya Pradesh. It is not sure. Yes. Yeah, here, see here. Can you see here?
Where is your pointer? Can you? Yes, ma'am. It starts from Gujarat only.
Gujarat, yes. Starts from there. So, flows through Madhya Pradesh, it even drains Madhya Pradesh and then back to Arabian Sea. Okay. Next is Bharatpuzha, right? Bharatpuzha is in down. Originates in Tamil Nadu. It originates here in Tamil Nadu somewhere. And then it drains the southern Indian states of Tamil Nadu and Kerala. Okay. Here,
I think it drains in Bay of Bengal.
No, all are drained in Arabian Sea only. It drains Tamil Nadu and Kerala. And Periyar, Periyar is the most important river in which Indian state? Again, not shown on the map. It is Kerala. Periyar flows to Kerala. So, again, it drains Tamil Nadu and Kerala. Okay, so down south, it is Kerala and Tamil Nadu which are getting drained with this rivers. Now, before we go to this, I just want to show you on the map how these rivers you have to mark. I have not done for all, but you will be provided with this map, right? See here. So, did you see here? So, if you are directly asked, okay, for example, again, I am saying if you are asked the river which is called as Dakshin Ganga. So, here you are going to write what? Here you are going to write the river which is called as Dakshin Ganga should come here, should come here. And which is the river which is called as Dakshin Ganga? Godavari, which originates from here, right? So, yes, Godavari, you are going to draw like this here and then you are going to label it as Godavari here. But here you are going to write what?
Dakshin Ganga.
Yes, what is asked in the question, okay? What is asked in the question? Okay, now a tributary of Indus originating from Himachal Pradesh. So, it will be this, suppose this is a question, this you are going to write in the index here, okay? Okay, so have you followed how to do that work? So, by the time, can you read the next question from the worksheet? Question number 4, 5, 6, can you read those questions? Yes.
Question number 4, a tributary of Indus originating from Himachal Pradesh. And this question number 5, the river source lies near Rohtang Pass. Question number 6, the river which rises in the Betul district of Madhya Pradesh and flows westwards, rivers that join Chenab in Pakistan.
Okay, so here the answer is the tributary of Indus originating from Himachal Pradesh, the answer is Chenab. Okay, Chenab, then the next is the river whose source lies near Rohtang Pass is the Ravi River. Ravi River, okay, the river which rises in the Betul district of Madhya Pradesh and flows westward is Tapi, Tapi River, and the rivers that join Chenab in Pakistan, according to your textbook, it is Jhelum. And if minor rivers are asked, then it is Tavi and Manwar Tavi. Okay, so these are the rivers. Okay, so again showing you the map here. See here, Rohtang Pass, so Bias River here, Ravi River near the Bias Pass. Okay, sorry, the Rohtang Pass. Okay, you are also asked to mark Chilka Lake in Orissa and Sambar Lake in Rajasthan. Okay. I think time is up.
If you like our videos, do share them and subscribe to our channel. If you want awesome quizzes, write to us. Keep watching and keep learning with Walnut.